Good afternoon. It has been a frustrating start to the long weekend for thousands of travellers trying to fly out of Sydney's domestic airport. Some passengers forced to line up for hours, others missed their flight. 80,000 people scheduled to walk through the gates today.
The line's just too long, so I missed my flight.
Everybody's just got to be patient and kind to the staff.
This is really, really stressful.
We'll check in on how conditions are at Sydney Airport a little later in the bulletin. Also today, major queues once again outside the Sydney Passport Office. Some travellers have been forced to wait up to 12 weeks for their passports.
We're still waiting for an email and they told us to ring back next week.
I haven't seen my family in the last 6 years. If my son's passport doesn't come in time, I don't know when I'll see next my family.
Some have opted to pay people on marketplaces like Airtasker to stand in line for them. Well, snow bunnies are flocking to the mountains this long weekend to make the most of conditions with the best opening conditions for the season in 20 years. Lauren Tomasi is live at Threadbow to cover all the action for us this weekend. Loz, try and dial down your excitement just a smidge and tell us how it's looking.
Oh, Davina. Well, I mean, take a look. It is so white, so much snow. It is the best start to a winter season here in Australia for 22 years. So the year 2000 was the last time we had this much snow on the opening long weekend. So I think that tells everything in itself. It's just incredible. It's so cold at the moment, about 0 degrees down here at the base of Threadbow. And the wind chill factor up the top is around minus 12. So certainly very chilly. It's been a long slog for the resorts to get here the last 2 years. Of course, COVID affected. The resorts had to shut down for such long periods, and skiing and boarding down here in the Snowy Mountains is just the lifeblood of the region. So certainly locals here are so excited to get things underway. And of course, the Queen's opening long weekend is, you know, really, it signals winter here in the Snowy Mountains, and there's been a huge exodus of people coming down from Sydney and across all over the state. Police are warning people, they want them to be careful right throughout the snow season, but certainly this long weekend there is a bit of snow on the road, so wanting people to take it easy. They spoke from Perisher Resort a little earlier today.
So our message, not only this weekend but for the whole 3 months, is don't rush, take your time. Go slow in the snow.
So look, things here at Threadbow will open up from 8:30 tomorrow morning. There's a huge part of the mountain open, which, look, it is quite unusual for the opening long weekend, so that is fantastic news. Perisher, of course, jumped the gun last week a little early, couldn't wait with such great snow conditions, but it's expected to be an absolute blockbuster weekend, and I certainly can't wait to get out and have a ski.
We're not going to hold you up any longer. You go enjoy it. Thank you so much, Loz. Well, explosive allegations out of Washington, D.C. about the January 6th Capitol riots. These pictures have never been played until today, showing a new perspective of the insurrection and the violence that officers faced. They've been collected by the U.S. House Committee as it undertakes investigations about that historic day towards the end of the Trump administration. The bipartisan committee finding the riots were an attempted coup, a brazen attempt to overthrow a government, that the violence was no accident, and that it represented President Trump's last stand to defy democracy. This from Republican Liz Cheney, once a colleague and political ally of Donald Trump.
You will hear testimony that, quote, the president did not really want to put anything out calling off the riot or asking his supporters to leave. You will hear that President Trump was yelling and, quote, really angry at advisors who told him he needed to be doing something more. And aware of the rioters' chance to hang Mike Pence, the president responded with this sentiment, quote, maybe our supporters have the right idea. On the morning of January 6th, President Donald Trump's intention was to remain president of the United States, despite the lawful outcome of the 2020 election, and in violation of his constitutional obligation to relinquish power.
Now, sample interviews were played during the primetime US television address, including videos from Attorney General Bill Barr and Trump's own daughter Ivanka, both who told the former president to accept the election loss and go quietly.
Told the president in no uncertain terms that I did not see evidence of fraud. and that would have affected the outcome of the election.
How did that affect your perspective about the election when Attorney General Barr made that statement?
It affected my perspective. I respect Attorney General Barr. So I accepted what he was saying.
The hearings could ultimately lead to a criminal case being mounted against Trump for inciting violence, but that is many, many years away. All of this, though, just the tip of today's explosive developments. Our US senior correspondent Amelia Adams will have more coming up very shortly. At least three people have died, another person in a critical condition after yet another mass shooting in the United States. The gunman opened fire at a business in Maryland. Authorities say there's no longer a threat to the community, police tracking down the suspect after he fled the scene. It's the latest in a spate of mass shootings that have rocked America in recent weeks. Well, Jacinda Ardern has declared a reset in Australia and New Zealand relations after a series of meetings with Anthony Albanese, including on the touchy issue of Kiwi deportations. Political reporter Jonathan Kersley joins us live. Jono, good afternoon. A seemingly successful first foreign leader visit for our Prime Minister.
Certainly seems that way, Davina. These appeared to be very warm discussions between two people who consider each other friends. There were jokes about music taste, even DJing, before serious political conversation, largely around a contentious immigration issue. Prime Minister Ardern has long been critical of the previous coalition government deporting New Zealand citizens who commit crimes in Australia, even if they haven't lived in New Zealand for decades and actually call Australia home. 2 years ago, Jacinda Ardern actually told then-Prime Minister Scott Morrison not to deport what she called your problems. Prime Minister Ardern raised the problem today with Prime Minister Anthony Albanese and last night over dinner at Kirribilli House. Prime Minister Albanese says he was listening.
Concerns have been raised that need to be taken into consideration as friends. We deal with each other in a mature and way which deals as well with common sense.
Of course, what I heard was a real awareness of some of the issues that we've long raised. Our long-standing expectation that Australia not deport individuals who have lived in Australia for a long time and are essentially Australians.
Prime Minister Ardern said the change in government in Australia was an opportunity to reset relations between Australia and New Zealand, pointing to what she said was friction between her government and the previous Australian government. Today, the leaders also discussed climate change as a central issue, as well as trying to deal with a more aggressive China in the region. In recent weeks, a Chinese jet has carried out a dangerous manoeuvre around an Australian aircraft, and Beijing's foreign minister has been jetting around the Pacific, trying to sign up 10 nations to a security pact. Both Australia and New Zealand on that front are keen to embrace the Pacific.
But you can see in recent efforts to try and create greater security arrangements directly with China, many of those nations choosing for themselves that they would stick more to an economic frame. But again, let's hear from the Pacific on these issues.
We're in lockstep on the Pacific. We're a part of the Pacific. They're our partners.
And what was clear today, Davina, is these two political partners, Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern and Prime Minister Anthony Albanese, want the relationship between New Zealand and Australia to go to a whole new level.